Today, I will explain what mathematical induction is and how to use it in detail. Imagine a row of dominant blocks lined up, and let's assume there are infinitely many of them. Our goal is to make all these dominant blocks fall continuously. First and foremost, the very first dominant block must fall, right? Then if the second block falls, and the third one falls after that, and so on, it means all the blocks can fall in order, correct? So let's summarize the conditions for the all dominoes to fall into two simple rules. Number 1, the first block falls. Number 2, if the kth block falls, then the k plus 1th block also falls. If these two conditions are met, we can conclude that all domino blocks will fall. Now, why do people often find mathematical induction problems challenging? It's mainly because they may not be familiar with the process of proof, right? Well, from now on, I want you to remember just these 5 steps for solving mathematical induction problems. Number 1. If the problem doesn't already have a name, assign a name like PN to it. If the problem already has a name, we'll use that name. Naming the problem like this often makes the problem-solving process and writing the conclusion much smoother. We'll simply call this process N. Number 2. We need to check if the first dominant block falls. We'll use the name we assign like P1 or the existing problem name. Let's call this step 1. Number 3, we need an assumption that says the kth dominant block or PK falls. We'll simplify this step as K. Number 4, when the kth dominant block PK falls, we have to ensure that the very next block PK plus 1 also falls. For simplicity, we'll refer to this as K plus 1. Number 5, if everything checks out in the previous steps, it is time to write the conclusion. Let's denote this as C. The conclusion will be in the form, since P1 is true and PK plus 1 is true whenever PK is true, therefore PN is true for all N. Now, with these steps clearly defined as N, 1, K, K plus 1, and C, let's remember this process and apply to solve various mathematical induction problems. Mathematical induction problems can be broadly categorized into topics such as divisibility, sequences, series, trigonometry, inequalities, and derivatives. In the upcoming videos, I will explain each of these topics step by step. Today, we'll start with a divisibility problem and solve it together, demonstrating how to use these 5 steps I introduced earlier to apply mathematical induction effectively. Let's use the principle of mathematical induction to prove the given statement. For all positive integers n, 3 to the power of 2n plus 4 minus 2 to the power of 2n is divisible by 5. We'll break down the problem using the 5 steps I introduced earlier, n, 1, k, k plus 1, and c. First, we give a name to the given problem as pn. So we'll say Pn is 3 to the power of 2n plus 4 minus 2 to the power of 2n. Next, step 1 involves checking if the first term is true. P1 is equal to 3 to the power of 2 plus 4 minus 2 to the power of 2, which simplifies to 3 to the power of 6 minus 4, and it will be 729 minus 4, that is 725. Since this value can be expressed as 5 times 145, it is divisible by 5, so the first term is true. Now, we have established that the first dominant block falls. We move on to step 3, where we assume that the kth dominant block, denoted as pk, is true. We use the expression for pn with n replaced by k. Pk equals 3 to the power of 2k plus 4 minus 2 to the power of 2k can be expressed as 5 times some integer m. With this assumption, let's move on to step 4 and check if the k plus 1's dominant block, denoted as pk plus 1, falls. Using the expression we previously defined as pn, substituting k plus 1 for n, we obtain pk plus 1 is 3 to the power of 2 times parentheses k plus 1 plus 4 minus 2 to the power of 2 times k plus 1, which can be further simplified to 3 to the power of 2k plus 4 plus 2 minus 2 to the power of 2k plus 2. Now, Can this expression be divisible by 5? It might seem challenging to confirm this fact solely based on this expression. However, we can leverage our early assumption that the kth term, pk, is divisible by 5. In mathematical induction, you must always make use of the assumption about pk when proving pk plus 1. Let's express 3 to the power of 2k plus 4 as 2 to the power of 2k plus 5m to facilitate substitution. We'll modify the expression for pk plus 1 slightly, making 3 to the power of 2k plus 4 times 3 squared minus 2 to the power of 2k times 2 squared. Now, we'll substitute the expression in the green box. This result in 2 to the power of 2k plus 5m times 9 minus 4 times 2 to the power of 2k. Expanding the parentheses and rewriting the expression, we get 9 times 2 to the power of 2k plus 45m minus 4 times 2 to the power of 2k. The first and the last term can be combined through addition, leading to 5 times 2 to the power of 2k plus 45m. Since this expression has a 5 as a common factor, we can factor it out, resulting in 5 times 2 to the power of 2k plus 9m. Ultimately, this expression is also divisible by 5. Therefore, we have shown that pk plus 1 is divisible by 5. We have now shown that if the kth domino falls, the k plus 1th domino also falls. This completes the induction step. Finally, in step 5, we write our conclusion. Since p1 is true and pk plus 1 is true whenever pk is true, therefore, pn is true for all positive integers n. By starting with a given expression and naming it pn, we made the problem-solving process smoother and our conclusion is concise. To recap, we used these 5 steps to prove the statement using mathematical induction. Step 1 gave a name to the problem. Step 2 checked the first term. Step 3 assumed pk to be true. Step 4 verified pk plus 1 using the assumption from step 3. And step 5 provided the conclusion. Remember these initials, and you will find it easier to solve problems systematically. Today, we apply the mathematical induction to solve a divisibility problem. In the next session, we'll explore other types of problems such as sequences, series, trigonometry, inequalities, and derivatives. If you found this video helpful, please subscribe and like. Thanks for watching, and this concludes today's video. Thanks for tuning in, and I'm your math guardian, Alex.